Hello students, I am Dr. Manish Puntambekar from Department of Management, the Bhopal School of Social Sciences. Today's topic we shall going to cover is the issue of debentures, under which we shall going to learn provisions of Companies Act to understand how to issue debentures with their rules. So my dear students, proceeding to our session with its meaning to enhance our basic comprehension of issue of debentures. Meaning of debentures: it's a written instrument or document issued by the company acknowledging a debt. It contains terms of repayment of principal and also payment of interest at a rate specified at the time of its issue. Generally, interest on debenture is paid half yearly. According to Section 2, under Section 30 of the Companies Act 2013, debentures include debenture stock, bonds, and any other instrument of the company evidencing a debt, whether constituting a charge on the assets of the company or not. Now, we'll discuss about features of debentures. There are so many features, but out of those features, the important features are: first, it is a written document or certificate acknowledging debt of the company. Second, mode and period of repayment of principal and interest is fixed. Third, rate of interest on debentures is always specified. Fourth, it is considered as long-term borrowings of a company. Fifth, it is normally secured by way of charge on the assets of the company. And sixth, interest on debenture is a charge against profit. It is not an appropriation of profit. Now students, the difference between debenture and shares. Here, the first base, this is ownership. As far as this ownership is concerned, a debenture holder is a lender, but shareholder is the owner of the company. Second is return. Debenture holders get interest at the stated rate, whether a company earns profit or not. It means debenture holders will always given their interest whether company has sufficient profits or not, because company has already promised to pay interest on their loan. As far as the shareholders are concerned, shareholders get dividend on this investment. Third point is repayment. It is issued for a specified period, that is debentures. Hence, the amount of debentures is repaid on the due date. In case of shares, normally shares are not repaid during the lifetime of the company. However, preference shares have a specified life and are redeemed on due date. Issue at discount. This is the next basis, number 4. Issue at discount. It can be issued at discount, that is debentures, but shares cannot be issued at discount except sweat equity shares. Next basis is security. Debentures may or may not be secured by charge on the assets of the company, but shares are not secured at all. Next point is convertibility. Debentures can be converted into shares, but shares cannot be converted into debentures. And last difference, that is voting rights. Debenture holders do not have voting rights, but shareholders, that is equity shareholders, have voting rights because they are the real owners of the company. Now students, we will discuss the types of debentures. Here, there are so many types of debentures, in which the first is from security point of view, So there are two types of debentures under this. First is secured debentures. These are secured by either a fixed charge or a floating charge on the assets of the company. Second, unsecured debentures. These debentures are not secured by any charge on assets of the company. Now the second point is from redemption point of view. From point of view of redemption, again there are two types of debentures. The first is redeemable debentures and second is irredeemable debentures. Redeemable debentures are those debentures that are repayable by the company at the end of a specified period. And second, irredeemable debentures are those which are not repayable during the lifetime of a company and hence are repaid only when the company is liquidated. Now, third kind is from records point of view. Again, there are two subtypes of debentures are there. That is, first is registered debentures. These are registered in the company's record in the name of the holder. Principal and interest of such debentures is payable to the registered debenture holder. Second subpoint, it is bearer debentures. These are not registered in the records of the company in the name of the holder. These debentures are totally transferable. Fourth point, from priority point of view, in which the first subkind is first debentures. These are repaid before the other debentures. Second is second debentures. These are repaid after the payment of the first debentures. Now, fifth kind of debentures, that is from the point of view of coupon rate, in which the first type of debenture is called specific coupon rate debentures. These debentures are issued with a specified rate of interest. It means interest rate has already been specified on these debentures. Second, zero coupon rate debentures. These debentures do not carry a specific rate of interest. Now, point number six, from convertibility point of view, in which the first subkind is convertible debentures. These debentures are those which are convertible into shares. If a part of a debenture amount is convertible into equity share, they are known as partly convertible debentures. If full amount of debenture is convertible into equity shares, they are known as fully convertible debentures. Second subkind is non-convertible debentures. These debentures are not convertible into shares at all. Now students, we will understand issue of debentures. Debentures may be issued. First kind is for cash. Debentures issued for cash may be issued at par, at premium, or at discount. Second kind, for consideration other than cash. It means the company has received the amount in cash against the debentures issued. In this type of debentures, it may be issued to vendors against payment of purchase price or to promoters for rendering their services for incorporating the company. And third, as collateral security. Borrowings of loans secured by mortgage of the assets known as prime or principal security. Security given in addition to prime security is termed as collateral security. Debentures can also be issued as collateral security. Now, methods of issue of debentures. Debentures may be issued in the following ways. The first is issue of debentures at par. Second is issue of debentures at premium. And third, issue of debentures at discount. Now students will understand how to pass journal entries in the books of the company at the time of issue of debentures. So the important journal entries are as follows. when debentures amount is received in lump sum. Sometimes company issue debentures in lump sum. It means company receives or accepts amount in lump sum, not in installment. So, following journal entries will be made in the books of the company. The condition is, on receipt of application money, it is bank account debit to debenture application and allotment account. It means cash is coming in the company through debenture application and allotment. When company will allot the debentures to the debenture holders, the following journal entry will be passed. Journal entry will be debenture application and allotment account debit to debentures account. It means the amount of debenture has been due. That is the amount of debenture application and allotment. Next condition is on refund of excess application money. Sometimes company may receive more applications at the time of issue of debentures. So it is called excess application. In this case, company will return the money of excess application to debenture applicants. Here the journal entry will be debenture application and allotment account debit to bank account. It means company has returned the amount that is called excess money actually to the debenture holders. Now students, we will understand when debenture amount is received in installment. Sometimes company may give some option to debenture holders that they can pay the amount of face value of debentures in installment also. So in this condition, the following journal entries will be passed. First, on receipt of application money, that is bank account debit to debenture application account. It means company has received the application money at the time of issue of debentures. Second journal entry, at the time of application money due, debenture application account debit to debentures account. It means the amount of application money has been transferred to debenture account. In other words, we can also say that the amount of application money has become due. Next entry is on adjustment of excess debenture application money, debenture application account debit to debentures allotment account. It means when excess money at the time of application has been received, it may be adjusted at the time of allotment also. And the following journal entry will be passed, that is debenture application account debit to debenture allotment account. Sometimes excess application money may be returned by the company to debenture holders or debenture applicants. So in this way, the journal entry will be debenture application account debit to bank account. It means company has returned the excess amount of application money to the applicants of debentures whom debentures have not been issued at all. Now, at the time of allotment money due, debenture allotment account debit to debentures account. It means company has allotted debentures and the amount has become due at the time of allotment. So company has transferred this allotment money to debentures account. Next, on allotment money received, when company will receive the allotment money, the following journal entry will be passed. That is, bank account debit to debentures allotment account. It means cash is coming in company's books from debenture holders. So all of you know, debit what comes in and credit what goes out. This is the basic rule of accounting. Next condition is at the time of calls money being due, journal entry will be debenture calls account debit to debentures account. It means company has transferred this call amount to debentures account only. And finally, at the time of receipt of call money, the following journal entry will be passed, that is bank account debit to debentures call account. It means company has received the first, second or final call money from the debenture holders. Now we will understand interest on debentures. Interest on debentures, this is an expense for the company, and company actually always pays the amount of interest to the debenture holders because company has borrowed funds and loans from the debenture holders. Therefore, it is the duty of the company to pay interest to debenture holders. Now you'll understand what is debenture interest. Interest on debentures is calculated at fixed rate on its nominal value, that is also called face value of debentures. It is payable quarterly, half yearly or yearly as per the terms of issue. The rate of interest is prefixed to the debentures, for example 10%, 12%, etc., and therefore is payable even if the company incurs loss. Interest on debentures is a charge against profit. Interest payment may be subject to tax deduction at source. Company always deducts tax from total interest payable to the debenture holders, and always company deposit this interest to the income tax authorities. Now, tax deduction at source, that is also called TDS in short form, we'll understand. The company paying interest on debentures deduct income tax on interest at the prescribed rate. The amount of this tax deducted is deposited with the income tax authorities because it is mandatory for the company to deduct income tax from the interest at source, and finally it must be deposited in government treasury. Now students, we will understand accounting entries for interest on debentures. Here entries for interest on debentures and tax deducted at source are as follows. First, when interest is due and tax is ignored, so it is debentures interest account debit to debenture holders account. The significance of this journal entry is, why we have debited here debenture interest? Because it is an expense for the company, and according to nominal account rules, all expenses and losses must always be debited. Now again question arises, why we have credited here debenture holders? Debenture holders are the receiver of debenture interest, and it is the liability of the company to pay the debenture interest. Therefore, all liabilities must always be credited. So the complete entry will be debentures interest account debit to debenture holders account. It means this journal entry has been passed in case of no TDS. Company has not deducted any tax from source. Now second condition, when interest is due and tax is deducted at source, journal entry will be debentures interest account debit to debenture holders account to TDS payable account. Here only one thing is new, that is tax deduction at source payable account, that is also called TDS payable account. This is the liability of the company, therefore it has been credited in the account. And the meaning of this journal entry, debenture interest account, that is an expense and all expenses are debited to debenture holders, that is the liability of the company, so debenture holders will be credited, and tax deduction at source payable account, that is also liability for the company, it will also be credited here. Now the next condition, that is fourth condition, when TDS is deposited in government account, journal entry will be passed in this case tax deduction at source payable account debit to bank account, or TDS payable account debit to bank account. It means company has deposited the amount of tax to the income tax department or to the income tax officials. Last point, on transfer of interest, to statement of profit and loss at the end of the year. Statement of profit and loss account debit to debenture interest account. This is the practice of the company. Company always transfer the amount of debenture interest to statement of profit and loss because this debenture interest is a recurring expense for the company and company always shows this into statement of profit and loss. So this is the final journal entry of this debenture interest that it must be transferred to statement of profit and loss. One more thing, debenture interest is always shown as finance cost in statement of profit and loss. So my dear students, today we understood how to issue debentures according to the provisions of the Companies Act. Its next part, that is redemption of debentures, we will understand in the next topic. I hope you might have enjoyed this session. Meet you soon in the next video. Goodbye. God bless you all.